Hi, Miss Melinda here, your spiritual worker from Miss Melinda's Metaphysical Services.com, here to bring you episode 3 in my series on tarot therapy. This is a chance for us to explore themes in the tarot cards as they apply to the medicine that we need within ourselves for healing and the medicine that we need in the world around us today. Because how are we going to heal the world around us? We're going to start with healing ourselves. So today I'm going to talk about the Queen of Wands. This is the Morgan Greer deck that I'm using as an example. The Queen of Wands is a beautiful, resplendent figure, very much correspondent to the energies of the sun, the energies of fire. I often work with the ghetto tarot out of Haiti, and the King and Queen of Rods in that deck is actually the King and Queen of Brooms. And they're these two beautiful figures sitting upon thrones, surrounded by sculptures and art, and their brooms are held upright with the broom on fire, very much invoking those energies of fire. What is fire? Fire is passion. It is inspiration. It is the impetus to create. It is creativity. These rods cards, these brooms cards, teach us to sit in the power of our own creativity, to sit in the power of our own inspiration. It teaches us that our power is going to come through our unique perspective, our unique creative outlook, our unique creativity, whatever that creativity may be. It may be a creative way of thinking. It may be a creative way of being. It may be a creative way of doing. It may be literally creativity, such as in creating something or creating art. The point is, this tells us that what the world needs to see, what the people around us need to see, is our unique perspective and our unique creativity, and that we should not be afraid to speak our own authentic truth and to sit in that power of authenticity, to approach the world around us and to approach our relationships and our situations and the people around us from that place of truth and inspiration and authenticity, to show others our unique way of thinking and our unique experiences that have made us what we are. And with that teaches us as well, in turn, is to act from a place of inspiration rather than from a place of fear. When we are fearful, we're acting based upon what we don't want to happen, instead of acting based upon what we do want to happen. When we're fearful, then we are actually repressing our creativity. We're repressing our inspiration. We're repressing our unique perspective. Because instead of allowing that to come forth, we think that we have to somehow prevent something else from happening. So the difference is allowing versus preventing. The difference is flowing versus protecting. So when we are feeling authentic, we are feeling inspired, we are feeling expansive, we're feeling warm, we're feeling open, we're feeling like we're in the flow. When we're feeling fearful, we're feeling anxious, we're feeling tight, we're feeling like I have to act now. We feel like we're coming up against an obstacle, like we're pushing, like we're resisting something rather than allowing something. Coming from a place of fear means that we feel we have to go out and meet something head on in order to take challenges in our own hands, in order to make things happen, in order to push things into action. Feeling like we're coming from a place of inspiration means that we know we can sit back, we can let things flow. We know that what we deserve and what we need is coming to us. We know that our unique blessings are matching our unique vibrations. We know that the universe has our back. We know that things are falling into place for us. So when we're feeling fearful, one of the ways that we can tell we're acting from a place of fear is what is our inspiration for doing things? What has ignited our action? Were we ignited by something that we felt we needed to express? Were we ignited by some kind of revelation or idea or experience that we had? Were we ignited by some kind of inspiring message that we received? Were we ignited from a personal experience or a personal story or interaction? Or are we acting reactively? Did we see something in the world and we thought, oh my God, if I don't do what that person is doing, then I am not going to be competing with them and therefore I'm going to fail? Did we see something in the world that brought up comparison? Did we see something in the world that caused us to feel like, that caused us to put pressure upon ourselves in order to act a certain way? Are we letting our inner critic take over? Are we letting a voice tell us, if you don't do things the way that other people are doing things, or if you don't compete with other people, or if you don't make yourself relevant compared to these other people, then you're going to fail? Are we following things based upon what we don't want to happen, or are we allowing things to happen? So these are some characteristics that you can start to think about in regard to acting from a place of inspiration rather than acting from a place of fear, or acting from a place of authenticity rather than acting from a place of fear. And I feel that these rods cards and these broom cards are a really great example with wonderful guidance in order to lead us in that direction of acting from our own inspiration and creativity and unique perspective, which really means being in alignment with our own authenticity and allowing our unique vibration to shine out into the world. Thank you so much for watching and stay blessed.